For many Filipinos, it was their country's proudest moment. The 20-year Marcos dictatorship overthrown, the peaceful uprising was known as People Power. The world watched as a widowed housewife named Cory Aquino assumed the presidency. As the Marcos family went into exile, there were high hopes that the Philippines would finally regain a place among the frontrunners in Asia.
25 years on, and People Power has taken on a bittersweet flavor for many Filipinos who feel not much has changed since they first reclaimed democracy.
8 months ago, Cory Aquino's only son was sworn in as the Philippines' 15th president, with one of the largest mandates in the nation's history. His mother had just passed away, and he inherited the mantle of ushering in change. Filipinos had once again grown tired of a continuing stream of corrupt officials.
The change of management was there, but the political culture lived on. So you have to get rid of that political culture if you're going to have really a meaningful democracy.
The Marcoses are all back from exile too. His widow is in Congress and his only son in the Senate, seemingly poised to be in the running for the next presidential elections.
I think there are fewer and fewer big misconceptions about the Marcos legacy. I think that the propaganda that was so rife in 1986 has been proven to be propaganda and nothing else.
For many Filipinos, People Power is now little more than an empty symbol.
That's what these people in Tunisia and Egypt have to watch out for. The same thing that happened to us. If they don't write it into their textbooks and educate the next generation of children that what happened was a bleak and black period in their history, then they're going to see Mubarak's descendants and Ben Ali's descendants come back in 10 or 20 years.
It was the first of its kind and served as an example. And 25 years on, as Filipinos remember, they also hope that the world heeds the lessons of its failures.